It was important for him to do it. He's done it.
Phyllis is going to have to, at least for a moment here, call on all of his experience, and it's considerable. You know, keep Rawls away from him, and yeah. Rawls scoring again. He's got Tillis on the ropes, and that's not where James Quick should be. He comes fighting back.
And you know, now, because Tillis was the first man to take Tyson Chen, though it was done subsequently by Mitch Green, it is now almost a kind of a watermark. If you can knock James Quick Tillis out now, you've done something Mike Tyson didn't do, and I guess that's a sign of a certain mark of achievement.
And conversely, going 10 with Tyson seems to be a mark of achievement.
Oh, yeah, that's for sure.
Yep.
Avery Rawls got his right hand in. Now here you see the experience of Tillis. He's been able to move a little bit, hold a little bit, and buy some time. And Avery Rawls not able to really capitalize as much as he would like on getting Tillis in trouble.
Now Richard Steele, who's nearly as big, he campaigned pretty good himself, but I think he was in the light heavyweight class, if I'm not mistaken, if I remember correctly. He's in some big guys to move around.
Tillis is relying on his left hook a lot. That's why Rawls got that right hand in. Over the left hook of Tillis.
Let him go, James. Let him go. No, hold it.
You can hear the instructions of Steele as we watch these two big guys bang away. Tillis very quick inside. Couple of nice punches. Tied Rawls up, moved away from him.
Wait. Jim Tillis is holding his left hand very low, and Rawls just looking for that lead right hand.
There's a right hand thrown by Rawls that connects. The Vegas folks here had made this one 6-5 pick'em. One guy said, boy, Vegas gives everybody a chance to lose, huh? 6-5 pick'em. I can't sure. take credit for that line. One of the lads in the truck came up with it. He'll go unnamed. But it is an interesting thought. Right hand thrown by Tillis, and then he grabs and holds. Good right hand thrown by Rawls.
Tillis just stood there with his left hand low and took that right from Rawls.
And Rawls just stuck his left hand out, kind of just holding it there, and then just fired the right, didn't he? Now Tillis brings him back in the exchange, and I think maybe Tillis came away the best with that exchange, and Rawls seemed to move Tillis off his feet as he threw that. Handful of seconds, and round two will be in the book. Things are heating up here a bit at the boat. Round three coming up. We're back in the corner with James Quick Tillis. We'll eavesdrop a little bit.
Look at me. You're letting this guy do what he wants to do because you're not moving. You're standing right in front of him. You hear me? You're standing right in front of him.
How can we watch?
You got to move. Pick off that lazy left jab. Pick it off, time it. Pick it off with your... with your left hand, hit him with the right, come back with the hook. You hit him with the body with the hook, but you're not coming back to the head.
Double Avery up. Rawls, double best moment right. In the second round. This freight train right. Look at the left hand of Tillis. It is way down at his waist, and Avery Rawls able to land it. At the end of the round, they both went toe-to-toe. The hand speed of Tillis becomes a factor. Left hand, you can see that left hook, though, slapping by Tillis. He's never been known as a great left hook artist.
Here we go, round number three. Tillis comes out a little quicker. Starting round number three, Rawls and he meet right in the center of the ring. Tillis, oh, good body shot from the hand.
Tillis used to have a very quick lead right, like the one we saw him throw against Mike Weaver in those highlight films. It's not nearly as quick as it used to be.
Toe to toe, they stand.
And you can see from that exchange how much wider Tillis' punches are than in the old days, than when we saw on those tapes. It used to be just a pinpoint straight puncher.
He still has the quick about him, though, at least for a given period of time in any one brief session in the round for 8 or 10 or 15 seconds, which can be a lifetime. His hands are as quick as ever. Maybe not as long. Doing pretty good with that left hand in this round now.
Yeah, he is. I think Rawls is making him feel those body shots and the right hands he's landed. Avery is a good puncher. There's never been any question about that. And you have to be impressed with how committed Rawls is to the body attack.
Tillis pecking away. Blocks that left. Picks it off. That's the place to be, I shouldn't think, for Tillis. He's trying to just manhandle and shove Rawls around a little bit. Minute 30 remaining. think the comment by Tillis in his corner went unnoticed, that he said, hey, I'll get him, I'll get him. You know, as if to say, I don't know, this guy doesn't belong in here. Well, Rawls, you know, is he makes no bones about it. This is the biggest fight of his career and the biggest chance for him. And he says he's worked hard for it. He's not going to come away a loser.
He's fighting in a very workmanlike fashion so far. It's obviously a very close fight at this point. But Rawls is trying very much to do the things he knows he can do against Tillis. Work the body and occasionally land that right hand.
I'm going to suggest to you that in this closing minutes, this round is going to be won by one of these two men, and it's pretty even right now. What do you think about it?
I would agree with that statement.
Somebody's going to steal this round in the last 20 or 30 seconds that we have remaining here in round number three. Who's going to impress the judges? And one form or another.
Roger, get out. Roger, get out.
A minute remaining. Round number three. Good right hand by Rawls. Nice uppercut by Tillis.
Come on, punch it, get up, punch it, get out.
Tillis with a nice combination. 15 seconds remaining. Tillis again throwing a couple of good punches. Nice uppercut. Left. Yeah. I think you know now who won round number three, don't you? That's it. We'll be back for round four.
Well, sure, how can I score? Avery Rawls, I mentioned the body attack, and he has really tried in earnest to go downstairs. And when Tillis languishes on the ropes, he can do it. You see him banging the body, feeling that he will slow Tillis down later. Tillis, though, showed his ability from the distance to throw some combinations, but it was the Rawls' right hand in that exchange that was really most effective.
All right, here we go. Round number four, scheduled for 10. James Quick, Tillis in white, Avery Rawls in the Cardinal trimmed trousers, they're gold, Cardinal and gold. Shades of Archie Moore. Archie used to show up in that formal length attire.
The old monk.
Ooh, solid right hand by Tillis, but Rawls didn't back up, just keeps coming on. Bang into the body. Well, you can hear that smack, and he nails Tillis with the right hand here in the fourth, and Tillis is giving ground.
Tillis came back with his own left hook, but this is the kind of fight Avery Rawls needed to make. I'll tell you what is really impressive about Rawls so far is his body work. Better, I think, than we've seen even in any of his other bouts. Tillis not fighting as one would expect him to fight. Again, not using his boxing skills as well as he'd like. Getting into exchanges with Rawls. Good straight right.
Yeah, Tillis. That's one of the few straight to the point punches Tillis has thrown. He's been kind of slapping with that left hand, at least in that previous exchange. Now they stand together and Richard Steele steps between them. Interested in the comments in Rawls' corner between rounds three and this one here, round four. They said, well, you won the round, but you lost the last 30 seconds. Interesting to see how the judges scored that. Because Tillis did have the flurry at the end of the round that appeared to carry it.
I thought it was a close round for that point, as you had mentioned.
Yeah.
Don't hold it, Mabry.
Tillis came in at 212 and Avery Rawls at 201.
Tillis trying to flurry from the outside. He's not as accurate as he'd like with that right hand, or the jab for that matter. Rawls, to his credit, doing a little better defensive job, I think, than Tillis might have thought he would.
Rawls has some sock about him now, so does Tillis, but Rawls has knocked out 8 of his 10 opponents. He's 10-1, and he's on a string of 3 straight coming into this one.
Tillis just knocked out Lorenzo Boyd about a month ago in the third round. He can still sting with the right hand.
Yep. He's almost jumping off his feet throwing that left hook, isn't he?
Yeah, and that is something he started to do in recent years in the greatest habit.
Yep, he nailed Rawls with a couple of solid punches. Rawls keeps coming back, throwing that right hand of his own. And he may have hurt Tillis with that left.
They exchanged left hooks, and Rawls has shown he's got a good left hook. He is not just a right-handed puncher.
And I tell you, pretty good chin, too, out there, Al. They've taken some shots each in turn. This is round four, scheduled for 10. All right, that's the end of round number four.
All right, don't lay in there, okay? Take a deep breath. Take a deep breath.
Take a deep breath.
One more. Okay. When he steps back from a Wendell's exchange today, but don't stand there and look at
Avery
it.
Avery Ross.
Take up the slack right away. Get back to the
opposition. With good right hands in that last round and the body work. That was, again, a trademark of him. Tillis from long range able to land some good shots, but by and large, Avery Rawls with that good body work in the left hook was able to get in there effectively.
We're in the corner with James Quick Tillis.
Work that jab, son.
Tillis being talked to. Now that's Eddie Futch over here on the other side. SportsCenter is going to follow our boxing tonight. Gail Gardner and Alan Massingale will be on hand. And the National League has announced its Cy Young Award winner for the year, and they'll have all the information bringing up to date on it. SportsCenter to follow. Here we go. Round number five. Neither man has been down. Each in turn has jolted the other, and this is a very close fight indeed.
Mike Scott or Dwight Gooden? I guess we'll find out, huh?
I would. You want to make a. We'll just take a guess.
I'll say Scott.
Oh, well, that's. We haven't got any. No bet.
Okay.
I think Scott wins it, yeah.
And the winner of this one very much up for grabs. I've got the fight dead even at this point.
In fact, I think I'm going to make a guess, a prediction, that Fernando came in second in the ballot.
Right. I shouldn't discount Fernando. Yeah. Look at Tillis turn to the southpaw stance. He's done this before. It's not the first time we've seen that from him in about. You know, an intriguing question as this fight goes on. Many believe that Tillis has the advantage because Rawls has only gone eight once, and in his last couple fights he's gone 2 and 3, and in the one he went eight, he lost to Mike the Bonnie Hunter. But Tillis has a habit in some of his recent fights of fading a bit later rounds, even though he's been 10 and even 15 rounds. So who will fade if this fight goes on?
True, Rawls has never gone 10. And with the adrenaline flowing, enervating too, there's no mistake about it. This is a big fight for Rawls, and just the thought of it and the exertion of it out there, much to say nothing of the abilities of Tillis, it's enervating. And think of going 10. Interesting. Something to think about.
Come on, you guys, let's work.
Richard Steele trying to pull him apart. He's a big man, 212 and 201. Tillis the bigger of the two. Minute 30 remaining here in round number five.
Work it out.
Neither man marked. Neither man has been hurt, I don't think, by the other. Only appreciable. Extent.
Lead right hand by Tillis getting in.
Yes.
And, boy, it could be such a good weapon for him, but it's not like he'd like also.
Stand by. You see the time showing, a minute remaining. This is round number five, and it's scheduled for 10.
Rawls is moving forward, Tom, but he's not really moving his hands very much. Now, we're in the fifth round here. I think you've got to watch him a little bit. Like I said, he's only been eight once, and in that one he lost.
Tell us, those punches are scoring, but they're slapping punches. That left hand especially. He's been a slapping at him.
I think we're reaching a key point in this fight. Tillis starting to understand that if he throws those flurries, he might be able to steal some rounds, and Rawls is loading up for one punch.
There's a smear of blood now under the left eye of Rawls. Apparently a cut there. We'll take a look at it between rounds. Under the left eye.
Keep him up.
No danger to the eye or the sight, but it is a nasty looking cut. We'll be back to see about round number six as the heavyweights get together here at the book. Shots as he's had so far in this fight, he slapped him pretty hard over there.
Hey, come on, it's working. You gotta work. This fight's yours if you work.
I think he's right. I think Tillis showed in the last round that he's now starting to hit that man Avery Rawls with some of the shots he wants, but he's not throwing him that often.
Right on the cheekbone, a cut that's been stopped and patched up. We'll see whether or not it opens and is a problem for Avery Rawls as the men go to the jab here to start round number six. You gave the fifth to Tillis, didn't you?
Yes.
Have him ahead by a point.
I thought he did more work consistently over the course of the round. Avery came back well later in the round. Good left hook downstairs, and that's the wild card. Rawls has done very good work for the body. Will it have an impact on Tillis as we head into the last part of this fight? A couple of low blows by Tillis.
Steel cautions both men to keep him up. Tillis trying to go to the body.
Break.
Rawls is in the cardinal and gold trunks, and Tillis in the white.
Well said today, I'm going to get into James Tillis's gas tank. And he meant that by going to the body. Of course, we're heading into the stage in the fight where we're going to see where that tank ends up.
just how far toward empty it is for both of them, I might add, because as you've indicated, the Rawls hasn't gone 10 ever. Now they've got their feet tangled up. Steele's going to talk to both of them.
Watch the wrestling, okay? Watch the wrestling, watch the hole, and let's fight.
He cautions both men, very emphatic about it.
I think probably most of that is being initiated by Tillis, who really, his game is down on the inside with Rawls, and he wants to kind of hold on until they can get elsewhere. There you see, Tillis immediately holds on to Rawls.
Yeah.
Well, they used to compare Tillis when he was younger to Muhammad Ali for different reasons, for the speed and the jab and the movement. Now, you could compare him to an older Ali, because remember how Ali used to hold on the inside, never did want to fight on the inside until they could break.
And used to sit on the rope with the old rope-a-dope and just conserve energy and confuse his opponents.
The difference is James Cook Tillis didn't develop in that middle period of his career as well as Ali did.
You know, it's interesting you bring that up, because with Tillis's comment prior to the fight tonight was that I don't sting like a butterfly or float like a bee because I ain't no Muhammad Ali. And he went on from there to talk about being the cowboy from Tulsa.
It's like comparing center fielders to Willie Mays as they did for years. That every good young heavyweight that's got some speed, they compared to Ali. Yep. Tillis especially was like that.
That's right. Well, this is round number six. Downstairs with the punch goes Rawls, but Tillis has been scoring repeatedly with combinations.
These are tough rounds to judge. Very tough rounds to judge.
Just a handful of seconds left in round number six. Tillis not all that quick, and Rawls showing the effects of what has been a tough five rounds and now six rounds as we await the bell.
Color time.
They're pretty patting with him. We got to dig every shot.
The man doing the talking there is Eddie Futch.
Get your head on the left side, okay? So you can get your head on the left side and zing those left hook kicks.
That's not Futch, but that's Eddie to the left.
Tell Torrance, the other man in there, who has been Rawls's trainer for some time.
Eddie Futch knows his way around heavyweights. And I tell you, just to be a fight trainer, trainer of a fighter is a lot different than training a heavyweight. Good right hand by Rawls, and he works to the body. Rawls trying to get himself organized and galvanized into action here.
He is showing right now he wants this.
Solid right, and he hurt Tillis with that, and he pounds him out of the body.
Remember we talked about James
Tillis' right hand.
Will to win, does he have it now?
Rawls is all over him and hammering away. Futch was on his case pretty good between rounds, telling him to get in there and take charge of this fight. Tillis now trying to fight back and restore some order from his perspective. Good opening 25 or 30 seconds by Rawls, though.
Avery came out and he said, I've got to go after this. And he is digging with the shots like they said. This is the time when Avery Rawls knows I've got to make this fight. This is a career fight. There's no question about that for him and for Tillis to a great extent also. Tillis always seems to come back to get a payday here and there.
Well, he's 136 professional bouts. A very long career, lost only 10, 25 knockouts. When you think of the caliber of fighter he's been in against, and he slaps away at Rawls, who keeps plodding in at him.
And here's where Rawls, with that initial burst, can't quite
maintain it.
Exactly. And Tillis, the wily veteran, able to pity-pat his way out of trouble.
Rawls hit him a pretty good right hand, but Tillis didn't seem to be as affected by it as he was a bit earlier, like, well, maybe in round two.
You saw Tillis land a good left hook and immediately hold on. Rawls continues with the body work. If there's one thing in this fight, though, Tom, that Rawls has done that is better than other fights, it's that left hook to the body and the head. He's shown a good one.
We're in round number seven, scheduled for 10. Nice combination, and again, from the jaw down to the body, thrown by Rawls. Tillis gets inside that left hook, and it slides harmlessly past his ear. Time. Hold on. What's going on here?
Time.
Well, Rawls got hit with a left hook just as Richard Steele was stepping in.
Some tape loose on the wrapping on the left glove. Tillis taking the occasion to rest up a moment in the corner, and now we're ready to go as the timekeeper continues the count here in round seven.
Punch again, punch again.
Well, after a great beginning by Rawls, Tillis has made this round at least a little closer. I don't know that I even winning it, but he's landed some good shots.
Rawls with a good jab, Tillis with a lunging left. Rawls chases him back, missing with a right hand. Nice left jab by Rawls. Steps in, the right is blocked, and Tillis ties him up. Coming to the close of round number 7. We're at the Showboat in Las Vegas.
Stop this fight. No. If you don't start working, I'm going to stop this fight. The guy is there for the taking. Do is put your punches together. You throw them one punch and stop it. Put your punches together, son. You bang, 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 and then you stop and hold. Step back and punch.
Well, Avery Rawls came out very strongly in this round, and this was at a point where he had just gotten a pep talk from his corner, and Eddie Futz said, you've got to sit down on your punches, and look at him. Good left hooks to the body, and that's been his staple throughout this fight. Later on in the round, using the jab very effectively, which he has not done all that much throughout the fight, Rawls able to push James Quick Tillis back.
And in the meantime, Bew Williford trying to build a fire under Tillis in his corner between rounds, and you were right there to eavesdrop on all of that conversation.
I wouldn't go to the bank on that scoring, even though I do, I'll stand by it, because I think Tillis might be ahead by a point. A lot of those rounds are very close, so don't be shocked if Avery Rawls is ahead on some of the judges' scorecards right now.
Remember, the three judges, not the referees, score this bout here in Nevada. 10 points, must system, the winner of the round. Tillis up, moving and dancing about. His corner wants him to stick out that jab, throw some combinations, then move around.
Avery Rawls very sorry that he couldn't get to the Olympics in his native Los Angeles, lost in the Olympic trials, and wants to atone for that in a sense by putting together a real solid professional career. We're going to be out in L.A. in a couple of weeks over at the Reseda Country Club, see Nunn and Ramos on your home territory.
Michael Nunn is undefeated. Alex Ramos is the state middleweight champion, and they say he can bang it around pretty good.
Oh, he's a former great amateur.
I tell you, Nunn is so hard to hit.
Very hard indeed. Yeah. That should be a good one.
Nice combinations by Tillis there, but then he fell right into a clinch. He threw a left and a right and then grabbed on. Williford was on his case pretty good about sustaining that type of attack. He's holding again as he ties up Avery Rawls. This is the 8th round, and Rawls has never been past 8. Minute 30 remaining here. Tillis banging away to the body. Rawls is a little slow getting off in this round, Al Bernstein. Huh?
He has not been as aggressive as he was in the 7th, and he pointed out, as far as he has been in the 8th round. Has Tillis done enough, though?
Oh, good solid right hand to the body thrown by Rawls. Minute remaining.
That's all right, let's
Steele says don't be pushing anybody out here. We're here to fight. No wrestling, no holding, no pushing.
Although we've seen a lot of that in this bout.
We have indeed.
Mostly initiated by Quick.
Watch your head. Work it out.
Pretty good left by Tillis. And again, punch or two. Not much in the way of combinations, and then tie him up.
Come on, punch this guy again.
Half a minute remaining here in round number 8.
Punch it, guy.
We're here at the Boat in Las Vegas. 10-round go between these two heavyweights. 2-3 unanswered by Tillis. Across the way. That's it. Round number 8 is in the books. The crowd wants a little more action in this one. I'm sure that if you step between this guy and Tillis, they tell you there's been plenty of it.
His hands up here. Dig with both shots to the body. You understand?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, but put a little snap in your budget. Bend your body and get your weight into your shot. This guy's ready to go. You guys got love for you. Let him hang around.
All right, as Eddie Futch berates young Avery Rawls about getting on with this thing, let's talk about basketball, the USSR team, and what a dandy bunch they are. They'll tangle with Georgia Tech tomorrow, and ESPN is going to be there for most of their tour throughout America. You'll see them Sunday against the University of Iowa. That'll be coming your way at 8 o'clock Eastern, and then they'll meet the Kansas Jayhawks live Wednesday. So